In this video, I'll teach you step by step how to make this mini robotic arm using 3D printed parts and other electronic components. We can control it using potentiometers, and it also has the capability to save and replay movements continuously. Let's get started. We're going to start with the electrical parts of this robotic arm. Here we can see the connections of each component on a breadboard. Additionally, I designed a printed circuit board to keep everything more organized and avoid using so many wires. If you want to have it manufactured, there's a link in the description to download the Gerber file. For those who don't know, PCB Wei is China's leading PCB manufacturer with years of experience. They offer all kinds of services, like 3D printing, CNC machining, injection molding, advanced PCB manufacturing, and more. And the best part? You can get started with PCB orders for just $5. Check the description below for more information and exclusive offers. Let's start by placing two 10 kilo-ohm resistors on the board, soldering them and then cutting off the excess leads with pliers. We place some headers like these, and to keep them aligned, we use other headers and solder them in place. We insert the headers where the Arduino Nano will go, flip the board, and carefully solder to avoid bridging the solder between the pins. Following the silk screen, we place a 10 microfarad 25 volt capacitor and solder it. On the side, we solder additional headers where we will soon connect some potentiometers. We place two 6mm side buttons with four pins, attach them to the board, and check that they function properly. Finally, we solder the DC power jack connector. This is how the board should look once finished. It's time to present the 3D design. I created it in Fusion 360, and I'm personally pleased with the result. In the description, you'll find a link to download this design, as well as an alternative version with the arm and a separate box for the potentiometers, in case you prefer not to use the printed circuit board. I printed all the pieces in black and white PLA using this 3D printer. This is how the arm parts turned out. One thing to keep in mind is that I designed them in a way that minimizes the need for supports during printing. For this arm, we will use four SG90 or MG90S servo motors. We start the assembly by placing a servo motor on the black base using two 9mm screws, but you can use another type of screw with similar measurements. We place the board we made earlier in this position and secure it with M1 screws, approximately 3mm in length. This is the cover that will enclose the base along with the circuit. For this step, four 10 kilo-ohm potentiometers like these are needed. Start by removing the nuts from the potentiometers. Next, place each potentiometer in its corresponding space on the cover, then put the nuts back on and tighten them. Solder these six wires to the headers as shown. Next, solder the other end of each wire to the corresponding potentiometer pins. We can use this diagram as a guide to ensure the wires are soldered correctly. I'm going to cut some small wires to the appropriate length and then complete the soldering process. I'm going to connect the Arduino Nano to the computer and open the Arduino IDE. This is the code we'll upload to the Arduino. The code logic includes functions to calculate and adjust the servo motor positions, manage timing for smooth and precise transitions, and control two buttons to switch between modes, like starting or stopping the recording and playback of movements. Continue with the assembly. I'll insert the Arduino Nano into the board. Now I'll insert the base servo connector into these headers. I'll attach this adapter to the shaft using the two screws that come with the servo motor in the same package. We place another servo motor on the shaft like this and secure it with screws approximately 9mm in length. Insert the plastic adapter into the servo motor and tighten it with its screw. Place this piece, which is the forearm, and secure it to the servo with two screws. Make sure it moves smoothly. Attach a servo motor to this piece, which serves as the base for the claw, and secure it with screws. Attach an adapter to this piece, which is a gear for the claw, and secure it with small screws that are 5mm long and 1mm in diameter. Place the gear onto the servo terminal and secure it with its screw. Position the other gear and secure it with a 16mm M3 screw. Then, attach these small bars to the base using 12mm M3 screws, ensuring they move smoothly. In a similar manner, attach the black clamps using 4 12mm screws. This completes the assembly of the claw mechanism, giving it its final shape. Now insert a self-locking M3 nut into this part of the arm, as shown in the video. Using a 16mm M3 screw, attach the claw to the arm, securing it firmly as shown. Next, pass the servo cable through the hole in the arm. We'll insert another servo and screw it to the arm as shown. We place the adapter and secure it with a screw. Then we join the forearm to the arm like this and screw them together. As you can see, our robotic arm is already taking shape. We'll place a cable tie on the cables to keep them more organized. Using pliers, we'll thread the cables through the black piece until they reach the base axis. Similarly, we'll secure them with a cable tie. Now we'll attach this small piece to the arm using an 18mm hex head screw. We'll fold a rubber band and thread it through the cables, then wrap it around the servo and the screw as shown in the video. We'll connect an extension to the narrower cable, arranging the cables to exit through the bottom, and then secure the cover with 2 12mm M3 screws. We'll connect the servo motors to the PCB in order. First the forearm, then the arm, and finally the claw. Now we'll take out the cover with the potentiometers that we prepared earlier. We'll connect the cables to the board. To ensure the correct positioning, we can follow this diagram as a guide. We'll place the cover and secure it with 3 12mm M3 screws. Now we'll place the axis on the base and secure it with a screw, making sure it's not too tight. We'll stick the black indicators on each knob we printed and finally place them on the potentiometers. To power the robotic arm, we can use a 5-volt 3-amp adapter like this one. We can also use a PC power supply. For that, we first need to connect the terminal of the green wire to a black wire like this. Now, we'll connect the DC adapter to the black and red wires that provide 5 volts. Now it's time to power up our robotic arm. The arm works like this. We control it manually by turning the potentiometers, and each potentiometer controls a different servo motor. In automatic mode, predefined movement sequences can be recorded and replayed. Pressing the button on the left saves the current position of the entire robotic arm, allowing us to store multiple positions. Once we've finished making all the movements, we can replay all the saved positions by pressing the same button twice. If we want to pause the movement sequence, we can easily do so by holding down the button on the right. And with that, our robotic arm is complete, ready to unleash its full potential. Thank you for joining me in this video. I hope you found it useful or learned something new. If you enjoyed the content, give it a like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to support the channel. Until next time, let's keep pushing the boundaries of what we can create and turning dreams into reality. See you in the next video. Goodbye.